to Accent on TV. Best of Poland and Europe. Right here on LA Talk Radio.
Okay, I think I will start the show. This show is so special for me. I feel like I'm in home. I feel like I'm back in Poland. I speak funky language, English, with my unusual accent. Learning, and never being perfect when it comes to this accent.
Yeah, you are perfect. Stop.
I'm perfect outside of that.
Some people learn accents.
That's
you know,
right.
They speak many accents.
And you already have one. We already have one. We don't have to learn anything.
And this show is called Accent on TV, the best of Poland and Europe, and of course America. In this situation today in the studio, I'm so honored. I'm so happy again, because the word happy will be here a lot heard. We will be using this word a lot. We have in studio beautiful family. I was mentioning hour ago on LA Talk Radio, Accent on Radio, that everybody needs to just tune in to video channel. New shows. We are honored to have our own TV show on the camera. But sometimes, you know, guests are not so pretty. Can I say like that? They're all gorgeous.
Not really, no, because they still know us. So I think
I love you people, but you are not so pretty sometimes. Today we have just the most gorgeous, you know, family ever. And as a family of Probosz, I will call you aristocracy of Poland, because in a way, that's who you are. Marek Probosz, actor, writer, director, teacher at UCLA, and star in Poland, star in America, beautiful, beautiful wife, Gosia Probosz. We'll be talking about their marriage, their successful recipe for being happy for many, many years together. Then, everybody is looking into cameras, the beautiful faces. We have a daughter and son. Daughter, her name is Valentina. She's 18 years old girl. Gorgeous. Everybody can see her face. Amazing. And all talents we'll be describing soon. And then you have this beautiful, amazing looking boy. Gentleman, young, gorgeous, 15 years old gentleman named Vincent Probosz. We have whole family here together. We had Adamek.
Adamek, yeah.
Yes, we had a great also royalty
with his daughter
to
and
music.
Son.
Yes, with daughter and son.
He just didn't have his wife because
wife is in Poland still. But yes, we had a great Polish family here too. That was amazing. And of course, Ilona Europa, the host and co-host Marek Bacik. We love what we do, and we are so proud to bring this family to all of you to just enjoy and listen to the live story. Hi, people again.
Hello.
Well, this studio requires close up. We need to talk very close to microphone. In Poland, we'll be saying dzień dobry, yes?
That's right.
Yes. Albo dobry wieczór.
Albo dobry wieczór. Oh, there you go.
Good evening. It's
that's
true.
Right.
Then
good evening.
You both are speaking Polish?
We speak, read, and write fluently in Polish, yes.
That
gosh,
scares me.
I failed.
No accent
whatsoever.
Yeah, everybody knows. I have a daughter, Natasha Miraja. She's learning right now Polish. I cannot wait for her to get her citizenship in Poland. Do you have one? You have double?
Yes, we both have dual citizenship.
Wow.
Wonderful. That's what I will be doing soon. And I'm hoping my daughter also will just work and travel Europe. That's what we need to give to our children, the contact with Europe. Yes?
Yes,
with the whole world, including Europe, absolutely.
The whole
including
world.
Europe, right.
Mareczku?
Yes,
how are you?
I'm good.
Are you tired?
No, I never
do you have
tired.
Headache?
Look at me, with body like this, you can't be tired.
No, you can.
And he has camels. Camels are very...
That's right, you know, there's something here.
Yeah, they are very strong.
That's right, that's what it is. You see, that's what I'm saying. I can't be tired.
Yeah.
But how can you be tired in front of people like this? Come on.
No, we cannot be tired.
You know, even they bring the energy.
Yes.
I'm sucking off the energy as I'm sitting right now. You know, they're gonna age like 10 years from now, because I'm gonna gain 10 years from each of you.
Okay.
I'm gonna be
we'll
so
be
young
you.
After the show.
Yes, it's true. We'll be sucking energy of these people and just becoming the happy, hopefully, or happier family, because we have a lot of to learn from this really amazing
family. I'm a happy family. I don't know. How about
yes,
you
are very, not, very not, happy.
Not this,
you have
not this perfect, beautiful family.
I'm the best.
I'm the best looking in a family. so let's get this straight, you know.
So
that's how it is, you know.
And you have a beautiful wife, and you are married again. I'm repeating.
We've been together 37 years.
37 years?
Yeah. Yay. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Now I feel like you both are babies.
We are juniors.
Juniors, yeah.
Your marriage
26
is
years.
26 years old, yes. Yeah. We need to talk closer to the microphone. 26 years old together. I need to repeat the same question that I asked Marek Probosz. How did they meet? That was very, very good story. I think he needs to tell us the story on a camera. Then now we'll be having proof forever. How did you meet your beautiful wife? Her name is Gosia.
We met in America. It was 1989, and there was a commercial in Los Angeles. Light beer commercial, Rubicon shot it in a beautiful hotel in downtown. And they were looking for Slavic-looking actors, because the theme was light beer, of course, but they were drinking it during the Polish wedding.
Oh, okay.
When a friend of mine came to me and said, hey, Marek, there's this, you know, I read in the trades that there's this commercial and they are doing casting on Sunset Boulevard. You should go. You should try. I said, are you kidding me?
You know, they're
I'm
doing
a professional
something
actor.
Else on Sunset Boulevard, too.
I love beer, but you know, light beer, not necessarily. But I like beer, but I dislike commercials, right?
Yeah.
I was classically trained. I'm a serious professional actor.
Right.
And at that time in Poland, we had no commercials.
Yeah, there's none.
So commercial was
and
something.
And it was 1989.
Right.
Yes.
There was
one
no commercial
year before
whatsoever.
The Berlin Wall collapsed.
Right.
And so I said, absolutely not. If somebody would ever see me in commercial, they would say, what is this Probosz doing? Yeah. He sold out. So I said, no way.
No way, right.
And he said to me, come on, just get serious. You know, Michael Jackson is on top of the game right now. And he's doing a commercial for Pepsi. I said, you must be kidding me. I said, no, I'm not kidding you. He took the remote control, just pressed the button, and I see Michael there between the Pepsi Cola bottles and woo!
having change your mind.
Fun, yes.
Right.
And it's not even beer, it's just Pepsi, right? And I said to myself, well, if Michael is doing it, the king of pop, I should think about it. And I went, just for the heck of it, like to experience new things, and I got the job.
Oh.
But I had no idea that there's bigger picture to this decision in my life
than just a job.
Because at the same time, simultaneously, this young lady was also approached and somebody told her about the commercial. And she said also, no, she never did that before. I never did the commercial before. And she went and she got a part. Now, the funny thing is that we got...
You got two lucky
amazing
people.
Story.
The bride and the groom, right?
Why not? It's amazing.
Bride and groom.
Yeah.
And then year later, they got married. And 26 years later...
That's right.
Look at this beautiful
Congratulations.
Happy face.
Thank you. Know. Yeah, you know, if I be
are happy, I swear to God, I know they are happy.
If I be policeman, I would give them tickets for beauty.
Yeah.
I'd be like, whoa, wait a minute, too way too beautiful. We got to take a couple notches down.
No,
got to do
so
something.
It's so hard to find so perfect looking people, and they're just wonderful people. I know you a little bit. I had you 4 months ago, and you are so just charming, so hardworking. And your honest description about even somebody will say, oh, he's arrogant. He doesn't want to play in commercials. But sometimes people in America do not understand our mentality, the Eastern European mentality, way how we were born and raised. Sometimes we really have a different understanding what is
which is better
right
than everybody else. Stop.
Of course, it's
we
yeah,
are
the best of Poland and Europe. But sometimes you are right. Being commercial was maybe below.
It was. Like Marek said, was selling yourself out.
Yeah,
yes,
that's
absolutely.
What it was, right.
And also, let's face it, I teach acting and I make the, the line there that there's serious acting.
Right.
There is television, there is sitcom, there is commercial world, right? It's all different. In commercial specifically, you are a product and you support the product.
Right.
So if my wife wouldn't look good with the beer, she wouldn't be there.
That's right.
Right,
but she looked good with the. Apparently, you both good look with
like
the beers.
Beer, the blonde girl, right?
I think so. She looks good.
That's
beer,
right. She still looks good. That's the whole point. It doesn't matter what she's holding it.
That's right.
You know, so
okay,
that's
Gosha.
Great.
Gosha, you fell in love with this beautiful man.
Instantly.
Instantly. Oh. Took you 5 minutes. We decided.
Five minutes.
What did you do here before you left from Poland? And I'm coughing a little bit. I don't know what. Something's in the air. I cough. Then sorry if
our
I cough.
Beauty.
Love is
our
in
beauty.
The air. Love is in the air.
Cheers.
Okay. Can you tell us? Yes.
What did I do in Poland before I
yes,
came here?
Yes, and in America when you came here.
Well, I left right after finishing high school. I left Poland and went to live in Sweden for a year and in Austria for half a year. And then
wow.
I came here and became, since in Austria, actually, I had to survive. I worked as a resettlement specialist. That's
what? What is this?
Yeah, what
exactly.
Is it? Yeah.
What is it?
Yeah.
Resettlement.
That summer, Vienna had 100,000 Polish refugees that were escaping Poland.
Oh, that's right. I was there. Yeah, I think I saw
there
you.
Oh,
yeah, you
work
at the resettlement thing. Yes.
It was funny, but half truth, probably.
Yeah,
there were
a
few organizations that were taking care of Eastern European refugees,
okay.
And especially Poles,
because
they were
huge
just leaving en masse.
Yeah, yeah.
Families
yes.
And singles and everybody and anybody who kind of felt that something is going to happen in Poland
wow.
was already out. And now the governments of these European countries had to deal with it, and that was a lot to deal with. So I worked for an organization called Tolstoy Foundation, which
oh, okay.
was
Tolstoy.
Started by yes. Irina Tolstoy, the,
oh.
the granddaughter of Leo Tolstoy,
whoa.
Initially
very
to get
writer.
Dissidents out of Russia. And at that moment, they were swamped by the Polish
oh
refugee
yeah.
influx, mm-hmm. so they needed desperately some translators, and I spoke English and Polish, so that
so you're the lucky
your
one.
English is beautiful.
Thank
really
you so much.
Very, very well.
Thank you.
Really great.
So that was what I did in Vienna.
And why did you decide to move to America?
I didn't. I wanted to go to Australia. That was my dream.
Really?
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, yeah, I got it offered to Australia too, actually.
It was very alluring.
Yeah.
And I had this dream. I needed to go to Australia. But my boss, a fabulous lady at the Tolstoy Foundation, said to me, listen, we have a proposition for you. Since you are doing such a great job here, you're a liaison between American Embassy and our organization, and you know all the ropes of the business, so to speak, you know how to deal with your people, how would you like to go to United States as a political refugee, start an office to receive all these refugees that
wow.
we'll be sending from Europe
wow.
to America?
Jesus.
We owe her.
I know, and it's amazing.
I said,
okay.
send me somewhere where there is sunshine,
preferably
San
California.
Diego. Oh, there is no office in San Diego. Okay, Los Angeles. No. We have an office in Portland, Oregon.
Whoa. Yeah. It's not really sunshine there.
But technically speaking, it's the West Coast. Okay,
it's
I'll try it.
2 days
close
a year.
To the ocean.
Yes.
Yeah. It is. It's close to the ocean.
You know?
So that was my story. I ended up there. It
too
was
green
my
for me. So.
In Oregon? I
it
mean.
It was extremely green. It was gorgeous.
Yeah,
Portland,
I bet.
It's
yeah.
just beautiful. But
yes.
I was only 20 years old. And for me, I
yes,
felt like I landed in a
place.
Hippie place.
It was a hippie
and
place.
Second like
time. And actually still is hippie place.
Yeah. Change
oh yeah!
You know, and
oh
all,
yeah!
And that was
it's the best
a bit too
pot growing
out.
Place ever. Oregon, go
Love
Oregon!
Perfect, yeah. Today, maybe I would have liked it a little bit more, but I lasted
no.
almost a year.
We say all no.
Yeah.
We love Portland on the picture.
That's right.
Okay.
So you lasted a year.
I lasted
awesome.
Almost a year, and
okay.
then my mom defected, and
oh.
she actually made it to LA because she went through a different organization.
Wow.
So
very interesting.
I came to visit mom. It's February, 85 degrees. We swim in the ocean.
And you're like, oh my gosh, this is
palm
nice.
Trees. What am I doing in Portland?
Yeah.
What an experience.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
That's awesome. Great story.
Then you moved to LA. Obvious.
Yes.
Then you got angels. Just got us you together
that's
on the
right.
same commercial because
right.
they were
and they actually play husband and wife
yeah.
in a commercial.
Yes.
So
yeah,
the destiny,
room,
destiny
absolutely.
Was already there.
Yes,
that it was right there. You guys
yes.
could have saved some money. Use the commercial for
that's
your
true.
Wedding thing.
Yes.
Your beer is there. Already cameras there. That's what I would do. I go, hey, it's already on.
Contact back
you know?
The beer company saying, look at
the opportunity.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's right. That's
okay.
right.
Yeah, I smell
you should go
here.
Back to the light beer. Goes, listen. 26 years later.
That's
yes.
Right.
We still together commercial. And drinking the same beer. Yeah, that's what I'll be doing. I go, light beer keeps you going.
I don't know, but I think we need to move to this beautiful, beautiful
kids,
couple, children.
What happened then? What happened the night 15 and 18 years ago? Actually, do you have pictures? What happened 15, 18 years ago?
You had 8 years before you had your daughter, and then you had a good 8 years to enjoy your life.
Oh, yes.
I want to know about how you enjoyed the 8 years of your first
we
8 years of your life.
We traveled all over the world.
Wow.
Talk
wow.
to
we
me are, more. Yeah. That's we what marriage is.
Absolutely.
Happy we marriage supposed to do, because we want the recipe for happy marriage. Then you do your life, both of four of you, your way. And I want to put accent on the way how they live their lives. I think it's something very special about the relationship that everybody has here. You said you took a time to travel. Why do you think this was so important?
You know,
and who wanted this?
One of
wife
my,
or you?
One of my biggest heroes in literature was Odysseus. Wow. Odysseus is somebody who loved to travel.
Right.
Okay.
Now, I love to read because I love to travel and imagine. And I'm not only my book that I wrote, Call Me When They Kill You, starts in Polish mountains, but it ends in another galaxy. So
oh,
I keep traveling with my hero.
You want to go there too?
Absolutely.
Oh,
and
why
I do
not?
I do go from time to time. I can
when you
give
close
you some tips.
Close your eyes, yes. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
And he's
but,
serious about that.
I love traveling.
Awesome.
I'm coming from the tribe of mountain people, and they also were escaping taxes that Romans imposed on them, and they were moving higher and higher in the mountains to disappear, and
I'm escaping
going.
Taxes right now.
Yes,
I know somebody who was skipping taxes
yeah, that's
for
right.
many years.
That's right.
And when I met my wife, I just met another traveler. Not only that,
that's
her,
a great match.
Her father was a captain.
Oh, what else do you? So you,
her mother is a captain.
That's so romantic.
Oh my
it's
gosh.
Like a movie in the making. Yeah. In
she
front of us.
Had on her little wall as a child pictures from her father sending her pictures
postcards
from all over the world.
That was crazy.
And she was dreaming about being there, right?
I was hoping that she have a picture of you when you were a baby.
Yeah.
That would be a destiny.
That
would be
a
like,
story.
Wait a minute.
There is a story.
Don't tell me. Oh, seriously?
Tell us.
Okay, I
magical.
Didn't have a picture of
oh,
my husband
God.
when
I was
he
like,
was a
oh
baby,
my.
But 2 years prior to our magical meeting, I had a premonitious dream.
Oh, I want to cry.
Oh, God.
Go ahead.
I know.
This thing's happened.
That's crazy.
People. Okay, okay.
And
what did you dream
screen,
about?
The whole screen of my dream, I would call it screen of my dream, was filled with an image of this handsome, beautiful, blue-eyed, blonde, gorgeous man.
I got brown eyes. I don't know what you were dreaming.
What did you eat before this dream? Do you remember? Maybe you can
really
give me this.
I was happy in my life.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Well,
okay.
I was
Rob
heartbroken and life broken.
Oh.
And things were not that great.
Okay.
So the dream came, and the omnipresent voice said to me, I swear it was omnipresent.
No, I believe
it.
No.
I
saw something too, so that's
body.
Why I can share with you. I got
and
the same
thing.
And the
voice said, this is the man of your life.
Oh, my gosh.
And it repeated several
like this,
times.
I'd be scared, actually.
At me almost. It scared me. Like,
right,
what
I bet.
Are you doing?
Wow.
What have you been doing so far? This is the man of your life. You better find him. So for 2 years, I was frantically looking
searching.
For.
Really?
Did you
searching?
Have a vision? How
that
to
is crazy.
Yes, I had a vision, but I had no recollection that I have ever crossed paths with this particular man. I even wrote to my best friend in Poland and described him to the T, but she said, well, it could have been
this person, that
but
person.
That was Merrick.
Know.
Okay, this is magical, and we love stories like this. We like very much stories like this. We want
definitely
hear more
but
about your happy marriage.
Yeah.
8 years
Marek.
Of traveling, yes?
Yeah.
You continue
so
with something?
No, but you can say
no,
yeah,
I
yeah.
just wanted to say
okay,
that
yes.
When you asked me before, you know, how long did it take me to fall in love with it instant,
yes.
I said it took 5 minutes because it took a little while to recognize.
But
once I recognized.
From the dream 2 years ago, yeah.
That this
wow.
is the man Mas- from the dream. It was 85 degrees. I was wearing a heavy wedding dress.
Wow.
I went completely into hypothermia. I couldn't breathe. my blood was leaving my extremities. Gosh. I had blue fingers and my teeth went. I couldn't say a word. I was struck by lightning when I realized that this.
Maybe
is
you really were man. Struck by lightning. That's what I'm thinking. You know, and you know.
I don't like your story.
Let me tell you. Don't it took you 5 minutes. You know, I met Merrigan. You know, my cousin's party, and took me literally 30 seconds to fall in love with him. So I don't know what you were waiting for.
But you didn't have a dream, right?
No, I didn't have a dream. It was like instantly. It was instant love. So that's what. No, but that's a great story. That's beautiful. That's amazing.
Okay, 8 years. Then you travel a little bit. What country did you visit?
Oh, we went to. We went to different countries, but we followed cultures.
Yes.
We loved native Indians, right? The culture.
Somebody nice. Yeah.
So we traveled to the Hopi reservation, to Navajo Indians, and actually we got
to Hopis,
and we got married at the Hopi reservation.
It's like a story. I'm just reading like
and
a book.
I can close my eyes and go.
So
okay.
Boring. I have like no memories of anything good after when I listen.
No,
to
I have good memories. Come
plain,
on, you
nothing
got two
happened.
Kids, you got good memories. Stop.
No,
you can't do
moment.
This. You can't do
in
this. You can at least lie.
Okay. Okay.
Great memories. She's got great memories with the kids. Remember.
Kids are
kids
the best.
That's right. That's right. If she doesn't. That's right. If she doesn't.
Okay, then you travel. You have this contact, and you had a wedding. The most.
We had the wedding. We were baptized there. We got Indian names. My wife's Indian name is
Bakavi,
and my Indian name is Owatsmo. And then it was unbelievable experience we had over there, of course. And then we went to Maya's land. Uh-huh. We went to Yucatan. We went to Aztecs land.
Okay.
We went to Olmecs, Zapotecs, to Incas. We traveled to Peru.
How long this took you?
Eight years.
8 years.
Eight years. That's right.
No. We did. We kept taking trips.
Right.
Okay.
I would surprise my husband with where we're going next.
Yeah, but Gosha, wow. You know, when we met, she's the girl who would just kidnap me, basically. I wouldn't even know. She said, tomorrow we are going.
There will be one kidnapping. What I wouldn't mind.
You know,
you'll be like, sure.
Takes a man to follow a woman and just doesn't question. Say, honey,
that's awesome.
Yes,
too from your side.
It takes that's some trust because last year she kidnapped me at my birthday and she said, you know what? Just dress, maybe comfortable shoes and not the most expensive jeans and you know, just sweatshirt and. I said, what else? Uh-oh. Don't take any money with you.
Yeah.
I said, okay.
Any valuables?
Yes. So
I've been thinking that she's going to kill me.
That's what I was thinking.
She blindfolded me and we were traveling. And then finally she took my bandana off and I saw the place. I've never been there before.
Uh-huh.
And I said, where are we? Still in the same country, right? She said, yes. And she took me further, and I see we are actually at the place where you do skydiving.
Oh,
I saw the pictures.
Okay.
I saw the pictures, and you did skydiving.
So this kind of trips, too.
That is awesome.
Did you appreciate falling down
for
safely?
14,000 feet, it was quite exciting, very absurd.
You both did this?
No, I did.
You didn't.
She's like, no.
High five. I love you. Okay, yeah, I will send my husband skydiving.
You will, but you would have given the parachute. You just go skydiving, jump. Just jump, honey. Bye bye. That'll be different skydiving.
That's amazing. So, okay, then, adventurous. The marriage is pretty adventurous. They both love to travel. They both just fell in love instantly.
Crazy.
From the same country, which seems like that's very, very unusual and special to find the person to marry in America instead of, you know, in Poland coming here. It's much easier, you know. But, okay, then how this happened that you have your career, you're a very big actor in Poland, you are still playing there and you have your name is very, very known and you have stuff going on in both countries, very serious stuff. Then tell me your support to husband happened instantly. You knew that he is a dreamer. He needs to achieve in life the most what he wants.
Yeah.
You knew that's the guy he is. He will not be like on the behind. He will always is force of the nature.
Yes. You know the
you are not scared of his dreams.
Oh no.
No.
Not at all. No. At first, I actually thought he's a liar.
Oh, even better.
His story wasn't true. You know,
Gosha, I love
don't
you.
Want to say it.
No, I, you know, when he was introduced to me, And somebody said, oh, this is a wonderful filmmaker from Poland, you know, and he made 35 films and these wonderful lead roles. And I said, yeah, sure.
Sure.
He looks 19 and he definitely shot 35.
19 right now.
He did. He looked like a baby. He looked like yes. Vincent's face,
oh
you know,
gosh.
Just baby
Vincent,
face.
Vincent, you're
so
a baby.
I absolutely disregarded that. Okay. I did not believe one word. And then when I realized who he is,
I know.
I went, oh.
That was a true story.
Yeah.
He's a tough.
He's an incredible man. He's my soulmate, my partner. But, you know, really, a man with a gift.
That's a role model for the kids.
Do you think his dream took away something from your life, or you think you grew because of his passion for acting, for writing, for directing? And obviously, probably beginnings were not so easy in America for his dream to reach to the point that he's right now. That it took 20-something years, yes? Then the beginning, you needed to believe, you saw his incredible gentleman, but still, I know, wife needs to support husband blindly.
Yes,
and sometimes it's tough to do that, probably.
No, actually, all I wanted to do is just to be
support
with him
blindly.
And do everything with him.
Wow, that's
support
that's
him
great.
In anything and everything, and because we were free, so to speak, to do a lot of things together.
Okay, kiss, please. Oh my gosh.
Let's beat the record.
That was the longest one. That's right.
But I want to hear this over and over. Because sometimes a lot of husbands say, oh, why we need to do everything together? Some people, my friends, say also, okay, marriage are two people who happen to be married. But to me, marriage is about intertwining their lives
be.
To the
it has to
for
be.
Sure.
To the and not counting that today is your day, tomorrow is my day.
No.
Is like what really is important right now. That's what we are developing, and the love towards both passions of both.
You know, it's crazy because
identical.
You know, same like you know, like semi like my story. I met my wife a long time ago, and now 16. And you never will even think about it that you're gonna be in love. And then literally till now, I still love her like I was 16. And it's great. It's really crazy because I always tell my friends, "Oh my God, she's my wife." You know, I'm excited about it.
Yeah.
You know
so
what
nice.
I mean?
What's
that's what I'm saying. That's what
absolutely.
Your story is. You know what I mean? It's you gotta have the love. You gotta
and
have
I
the compassion.
Marriage
you gotta,
needs to
you know,
go through life together.
You have to. You have
if
to.
You have two separate
you
lives
can.
In
no.
a marriage,
no. Right.
No. That's not a marriage. Worse for some people.
It's for better
but
and
I
worse.
Think the
not
best.
For better.
For better
the
and for worse.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
And then what happened after the 8 years?
You ask me if it took anything away from me.
Yes.
No. It did not. Actually, I think that. Our family life, what we created, took away from Marek.
Well, now Marek will say no.
I think he loves
well,
it.
In a way,
tell us.
He let go of a lot of his dreams
okay.
to be with us, to
right.
create family, to have what we have. It takes a sacrifice.
Oh yeah, it's
it does.
Huge sacrifice.
Are you leaving a lot? Your wife and children?
I do travel, but there was a time when Valentina was born. I wanted to add to it that when Gosia got pregnant with Valentina. We decided that she will deliver our children at home, and
who decided?
Well,
we.
Both of us.
That
oh,
was we.
Yeah,
he said we decided.
Yeah. So
actually, Marek came with the idea first.
And you're like, sure, I'm on board.
Okay.
Well,
that's
awesome.
I don't know if I like that, but okay.
So Valentina and Vincent were born at home, which means a lot to
oh
be
yeah.
there
oh
when
yeah.
your wife
yeah.
is delivering so. The baby. To see your child coming and to support your wife with the birth.
Oh, you yeah.
screamed more.
You know what was.
I
did.
No.
Oh, I'm the screamer.
You knew that they are coming a few years later. I'm there with this family. Love it.
But the bonding is such that when Valentina was born, I can only compare this moment to creating a human being. This is the moment when you see. That if there is anything that was passed from God straight, the lightning, we were talking about Zeus sending that lightning to enlighten human being, is definitely the moment of your child coming to the world.
Oh, yeah.
And the bonding moment. So when Valentina was born, and I just took her to my arms, and we had our first eye contact,
right.
and the,
eye to eye, right.
the look locked,
yeah.
right? It you just, the space within you opens, and you... No, you don't know how you know, but you know what it is, unconditional love.
Oh, yeah.
And you know what family is. If you're ready for it, of course, you have to be there
right.
on the spiritual level, on any other level. you have to be ready to take the responsibility for this arc, which is traveling, the love arc.
And forever.
And it's forever.
Short period, longer period.
There's no end to it.
This is, I think, a lot of marriages in the beginning start maybe similar, and fathers
no
and mothers love children so much, but true
love
happen
ends.
Later.
No,
true love never ends.
I will say too. You need
there
to
is a beautiful
know
phrase,
what love is.
Poetic phrase that love is stronger than death.
Yeah.
And that's true.
Yeah, that's true.
True love never dies. Mm-hmm. And this is a perfect example. We have continuation of our love, right?
I know, and you guys did. You know, I just want to tell you, you guys did a good job.
Created perfection. Picture perfect children.
Thank you.
Boy, what a nice, elegant children they are, and how talented they are. Then let's start from the beautiful lady. You are 18 years old, Valentina.
Yes.
And I will say, yes, you can get much. You move this microphone. I want people to hear you and look
you
into camera because everybody needs to see how gorgeous you are.
Thank you.
Then, honey, you are now in college.
Yes.
What is this college? You are 18.
So I'll be starting my first year at UC Berkeley in the fall, in August, actually, late August. And I'm going to major in environmental design and minor in performing arts.
Okay, now we are talking about two different unusual fields,
right,
in a way. And for right now, I think you are developing so strongly your love for acting, for music, for singing, and just loving being part of this family. I would love to to know and from you, you start playing violin in age of 6.
Right.
Then again, 6-year-old child, violin, and you know what? She didn't stop playing violin 6 months later and then move to the swimming and then move to the, I want to do nails and then move to something else. Like a lot of people around you,
the
children are just treating everything like it's a hobby. And to me, I think we need to teach our children to just stick with something, obviously they need to like what they want to practice, and violin is a tough instrument to love. You need to be a very special human being. Ben, I think you had this contact, very special contact with this instrument, that 10 years later, you are still in love with this instrument. Tell us what's happened when you first time heard and saw violin. Where was it?
I had a very special connection with the violin the first time. It was actually through my uncle. He plays folk music and gypsy music. He's from the Polish mountains, and he carves his own instruments, you know. So he kind of, well, first of all, he and my grandpa really taught me this connection to the forest, to the land that they come from, to the people, and the music. You know, the music, nature is part of the music.
Yes.
And I think at the same time that I was developing this love for my homeland, I was developing the love for the music that comes from there. So I fell in love with the violin when I saw him playing the violin. And that was at the age of 6. And from then on, you know, my mom asked me if I would like to try, and I said yes, and my first teacher was my uncle. So, and it was a very unorthodox way of learning violin, because he, you know, he taught himself. He was self-taught. So, but that's what I loved so much about it, was that there was no structure that was enforced on me. It was all creative, and it was all, you know, doing things, exploring the way I wanted to. And yeah, so. And then I continued. And
10 years later, you are continuing to play violin. When you came back to America, you found out that this instrument requires hours of practicing.
Every day.
Classical music is just the toughest. It's on
brutal.
Violin, you need to have perfect hearing. And again, you cannot miss, you know, any note there. Because everybody's running under the table when we hear this note that violin can produce. If it's not played perfectly, then I will jump right away to your success, because with orchestra from high school, can you tell us where did you travel with your orchestra?
Well, I went to Santa Monica High School, and that with my symphony orchestra, we traveled to Vienna, Prague, and Baden-Baden, and it was a tour where we played in concert halls. So, and one of the concert halls that we played in, it was Dvorak Hall in Prague. And that was the most amazing one, I think, because that's where Dvorak premiered the symphony that we were playing. So that experience was, I think, incomparable to anything I've ever experienced.
Please, people, listen and watch her face. you know, the girl is traveling. The girl is loving classical music. She spent 10 years of practicing violin. She is in Berkeley right now. She has parents like that who are just so talented, so loving the travel. the father is a very known actor. Mama, we know her past. What a smart and eloquent and just very, very amazing lady. And, you know, now we have product of this beautiful love, the love, great, great girl. She is an actor. Yes, you are a singer. You have some success with recordings. Could you tell us your voices in a movie?
I recorded for a Swiss film with the composer and professional cellist Martin Tillman. We recorded in a studio, and it was my first time, you know, recording a soundtrack.
Listen to me, first time in a studio. I just recorded. I mean, a Swedish
so
movie
with her.
You know what? Again, I think the right things are coming in the right time. Obviously, this girl didn't wake up and said, "Okay, I can sing." I think it is a years of training. Years of loving music, years to understand what music is about. And if people listen to the radio, Ilona Europa loves to develop young talents. I cannot wait to start working with this beautiful girl because I think the singing dream is in her. Obviously, she has better things to do right now. She will be studying in Berkeley, but if time is and is right time, who knows what will happen, because she wants to be a singer also, okay? Now, we cover the movie, we cover acting. What was about acting? You were acting in some movies?
I acted in a short film. It was a student at UCLA. It was her project. And it was a film about bullying, which I think it's super important.
Especially.
It's been going on for a long time. But especially now, when all of this is surfacing and people are having enough courage to come forward and talk about
I think right now people recognize what bullying is about.
Yeah.
Before it was like,
just a player on the poster.
No. We know when we heard
bullying do a lot of damage.
When we hurt somebody's feelings. That's what bullying is about right away. Then you are on the way to dream to become a very smart lady and probably bringing something very important to this society, because you have like the bigger picture what you want to do in the future. What will be in the future when you finish your studying? What do you be doing?
I don't like to put a paved road. I like to kind of leave it open.
Very good.
My passion, I think, or what I would like to do is develop these sustainable societies and sustainable cities in different countries and internationally. Okay. I think that it's not something that can only be enforced in one area, you know, because that's where I'm from. I think that it's something that the world needs. And
sustainable, what do you mean by that?
Sustainable is, it's more like ecological and
friendly.
Yeah,
everything
exactly.
works for the reason. Nothing's wasted.
And
things have a sense.
Right. And you have to take into account, you know, where we're going right now.
Yes.
The world is moving forward at a pace that we can't really keep up with if we keep developing like this. So I think that, you know, using sustainable materials and
just
studying,
be aware of what
exactly,
we do, why we
cultures and sociology and
it's
all.
It's not
this
so
stuff.
Hard. It's just awareness.
Yeah.
Somebody needs to talk out loud about that, and maybe people will focus. And it's not so
right.
hard to change your ways.
But
around.
You have to again commit to it.
Right.
You know, Valentina
you
also
focus,
is,
yeah.
is a vegan, and it's her choice, and she's a vegan for a long time. How many years now?
I've been vegan for about 3 years and
wow.
vegetarian since
That's
I was
11.
That's
a commitment.
11 since
yeah.
11.
I was vegan
since
for 5 11. Minutes. 5.
Because you're a chow, I don't know.
Really? Yeah, here you go. You
and,
see?
And another thing that Valentina was in Team Marine, which was a group of young people who were taking care of nature and ecology.
It's
aware.
An environmental
team,
and we did multiple science projects, and we got published in science journals. So that was actually, I think, what pushed me onto the path that I'm on now, because, you know, just having contact with people who you realize, wow, they don't think the same way I do, you know, and or they're not aware of this issue and this issue. And
then we have many ways that you can do what you are preaching right now in a very beautiful way.
You
can dance, because you are also a dancer,
right.
About that. We have very nice video that we can produce in the nature. You can focus on it.
Right.
You are a singer. You better start writing good lyrics that
That's
people
right.
will be aware
support
about beauty
cause.
And
yeah.
support the cause.
Yeah.
Obviously, you are studying in one of the greatest school in America, then that will be covered. You are so gorgeous.
Thanks.
You are so eloquent, and I could listen to you forever. And good things are in front of you. But then we have your brother. Brother, in a way. And I'm watching, and a clock is crazy. We have 10 more minutes.
Yeah.
It's just really, the hour always goes
Time
so fast. 50 minutes when you have fun.
Exactly.
Then, Vincent, you look into camera. Please
That's
turn
right.
your head. Everybody needs to see how gorgeous this gentleman is.
Thank you.
He looks like he looks like a young Merrick. If we put him right next to each other, yeah. It's like Merrick when he was 15.
Yeah, exactly.
And Merrick now.
We have some pictures. Yeah. I took a picture when I was Vincent's age and I put it on a wall and I took Vincent's friend and I said, look at those pictures. Oh, Vincent, that black and white picture is fantastic. You know, who is around him? He didn't recognize.
Really?
Him.
Oh, you see, they got from.
Oh yeah, we looked identical.
It's crazy. That's awesome. Now, at least you know that's your son.
That's right.
Okay, Vincent, we need to know a little bit about you. You have so many things going on in your life. Oh, yeah. Also, in some way, you turn into sport, and that's your dream. But you had a choice between two passions, yes? Which they were also daddy's passion in Poland. You are talking cycling?
Yes, I was. My father was a professional cyclist and soccer player for a short period of time. And when I was younger, I had two choices. Well, I had unlimited choices. My parents let me choose whatever my heart desired. But it finally came down to cycling and soccer. And so for a very long time, until actually my school PE teacher helped me decide, I was very undecided and I really wanted to follow in my father's younger footsteps and pursue his earlier dreams. And so I just decided to take the road less taken and go and pursue soccer. And it's become my dream, my passion, and everything I live for now.
You are successful in it. Please tell us what's going on. When you are flying and where?
Yes. Actually, on Monday next week, I will be flying over back to Poland in Europe, and I will be training and playing with the Polish national team for soccer under 17 and representing my country.
Congratulations.
And I'm very excited.
I got so many wrinkles after this hour and a half because I cannot stop smiling in a so sweet way. And again, I like to put accent on certain things that we are talking about. Sometimes we don't believe that good marriages exist, that beautiful families can really have amazing life together. The children could be just beautiful and sweet children and just loving family loves because they really do instead of they pretend they do. And also the parents are so supportive of children that they let them fly. And I'm not saying fly on airport only, airplane only, just fly. Do
open the wings and
that they
go
watch
for it.
And support every decision the children are making because that's how it's supposed to be in life.
Yeah.
And you leaving to Poland for 1 month, you'll be there alone. I know it's Poland. I know you are familiar a little bit with the country, but still, daddy, mommy in America, son is in Poland. Yeah. Okay, 1 month and he's back, but you know he'll be back and then he will go again. I know that's what he wants. 15 years old gentleman. Yeah. The same with daughter. Right now she's gone to her studying. She is with orchestra, traveling everywhere where she wants to. Parents are in America, although daddy is also flying all over doing his great project. Mama, we never mentioned what you are doing here.
That's
what
right.
You
we
were doing
we
right
need
now.
To have another
well,
show with just
I
Mama.
I want a little bit because you. You were master of yoga, yes? You had your own classes, and in every life is not only beauty and happy and sweet. Sometimes sad, crazy things happen in your life. Both of you, your son and you, just got into car accidents separately. Yeah.
That's right.
You, we didn't talk about this. We have only 5 minutes. I'm so nervous to say everything. But in a way, you, 3 months, six, how many
in
months?
October,
ago?
So
in October. In October, almost your dream was crashed.
Oh, yeah.
You got hit by the door of the open car car or whatever. And it took you 6 months right now to get to the form that you think is the best in your life. I'm speeding up because I heard this story. But how do you still feel pain of this?
Yeah, I recently, actually, just 2 weeks ago, finished physical therapy for my shoulder. And I still have problems with my knee, but... it's been a hell of a recovery. I've been just working as hard as I can, and unfortunately, I do feel pain and I struggle sometimes. But it's just obstacles in life that I go around and.
That's again,
through.
We put accents that is rosy and beautiful and happy, and we think sometimes a little jealous. Oh gosh, you know they're gorgeous. They have everything.
But
they travel. They love
problems.
Each other. But it's always problems, some problems. Always. Now coming back to Mama, to Gosia. You are a very smart lady, and you had your business, yoga. You needed to stop doing that. 6 years ago, you got into a car accident.
Yes. yes, it was. It was a tragic car accident, I would say.
Jeez.
Somebody who was texting, speeding, failed to see a stop sign.
Oh my gosh!
Because she was busy texting. Mm. I wanted to say it was a girl, but actually it was a 36-year-old woman.
Okay, not always children. Yeah.
Please don't text and drive.
Please don't do this. Children, especially
teenagers.
It
changed our life dramatically.
Oh, I bet so.
Now your passion, your business, needed to be folded.
Yes.
Yeah,
but for time being.
And you found another passion. You are Reiki healer. Could you tell us?
Reiki healer.
Reiki.
Yes. It's energy healing. It's beautiful. It actually is not my energy or your energy or anybody else's. It just flows through
the universe,
through me as a vessel.
Wow.
And it is from the source, whatever that means to you, but it comes from a very loving, beautiful place, from the light, from the source, I would say. So
but when you are receiving, but you are receiving energy, you are allowed.
I'm just allowing.
You're just allowed to go through it.
Yes.
You know how to channel that.
Okay. Right.
Can you be around her when these things happen?
Yes.
Or you?
Well, she,
yes,
she, when Vincent gets sick, or Valentina, or serious illness, is also, you know, my wife was approached with, and she helped other people with Reiki. Gosha just takes care of it, and
the recovery is just instantaneous. It's really blessing. How quickly it works. It's just pure love and energy flowing through you, and
I will have
heals everything.
This lady and another lady, Yelena, who is just passionate about this topic too.
Reiki, yeah.
And she's just becoming right now the healer, and the amount of studying that she's going through and the conversation around the table that and her passion is just so special. But I am not the one who can easily conversate on this topic. And it's beautifully to have two ladies who will just maybe explain to all of us a little bit more about what it is or how to get in touch with Gosha, which obvious to get in touch with Gosha, everybody needs to go to my Facebook page, Axenon, the best of Poland and Europe, and Axenon Radio, which I have linked post and our show here. Right now is ready for downloads anytime when we want, and the first hour before can be heard, and we all can learn the people's names. 4 more minutes to go, but I would like to again say thank you, because we have 4 more minutes, but reminded Marek Probosz, Gosia Probosz, wife, beautiful Valentina Probosz, and Vincent Probosz. It's just perfect family. This is a family that we want to be surrounded forever and ever and ever, and knowing that maybe they can teach us something.
Did you tell them we're going to move into their house next week?
Gosh,
I mean, we're going to be surrounded forever and forever. He's leaving. There's a room opening.
Okay.
She's leaving.
She's leaving. Ilona, we got a chance.
Okay, we have 3 more minutes. Oh,
that's
okay.
Right.
Okay. He's a star, whatever you say. We are the less stars. Here, I am a star too, but for myself. But you are a star, and you have so many things going on in your life, and we have very important project that you are just working on. And look at it, it's 47. If you can give us 2 minutes pitch on what is this film about, what you were doing in Chicago few times already, and it's very important, it's very political, and it's real scary stuff.
It's a political thriller. The movie is called Smolensk. So it's the name of the place where the plane crashed with the Polish government 5 years ago, including Polish president, first lady, and 96 people, key people to the government. Of course, they were flying there in one plane, unfortunately, to pay honor to Polish officers who were murdered during the Second World War in Katyn, by Stalin, and till today, actually, official version is still very vague, and nobody truly admitted or apologized for what happened.
Yeah.
So Polish government with the president was flying there to make sure that the world knows about the crime, about this massacre, and the victims are being honored in the right way. And we also talk about other unknown mass graves, which are still in Russia, and nobody talks about people that just vanished, disappeared, and we are talking millions of people.
Right. Oh yeah.
So that's
millions.
I was lucky to be in this very controversial project, which is the official version is the plane crashed, the fog was too thick, the pilot didn't know how was the altitude, etc. But this is only the official version given to us by Russian president, because he was doing investigation in Russia, and the plane still, which crashed, entire plane is still in Russia. The black boxes are in Russia. Right. Now, the unofficial version, and there are many facts, leads straight to conspiracy. There was conspiracy behind what happened.
And I would go there with this version.
Yeah,
and you said the movie is, I'm watching the clock, that will be this year or
the end. The movie is already shot, and the editing is happening right now. The sound editing is happening right now. So the movie is going to be out either before holidays this year or the beginning of next year.
And
maybe
you will be back. You will be back and describing and promoting the movie.
Of course,
okay?
Of course. Yeah,
that's
I would love
all
to.
We'll be doing.
I would love to.
I cannot wait. There's again, 7:50. I think we need to say bye bye for today.
Let's just, two more words. Yeah. I'm also flying to Chicago again to be the member of the International 51st International Film Festival, Chicago International, which is one of the biggest festivals in the world.
Right.
I'll be the member of the jury, so I'll make sure that good movies are being awarded.
Oh yeah.
And it's a big honor. I know that Sharon Stone is going to be another person with me on the jury, and there are a few more people. But another thing I wanted to mention is I just a week ago talked to the deputy and the librarian of the Coxsackie Maximum Security Prison in upstate New York, because 1,100 inmates there, life sentences, death sentences. And the librarian decided 2 years ago to bring some humanity to those people. And they were thinking about book club, one book a year. They would study, talk about incredible story or hero, and they picked the Auschwitz volunteer, beyond bravery, Captain Witold Pilecki, that I portrayed. They called me now, and they are asking me to come with the movie, talk to the inmates talking about good energy, talking about real heroes, about what
right
is
now.
Possible is for any artist to break beyond time, races, culture, religion, sex, etc.
Looks like we
I'm sorry.
I just hating the clock. Watch. I don't like it.
But there's no time.
You will be back. All of you will be back. You are our family here, Accented family. You are.
I love
best
my family.
Poland,
yeah,
Europe,
good,
and
good.
America,
we love you,
for
family.
Sure. Ilona,
I'll see you
Europa,
next week.
Marek Baci. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Good night. Thank you.
Monday.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Hold on, guys, because we have
You're listening to Accent on TV, best of Poland and Europe, right here on LA Talk Radio.